Minnesota Vikings signed two players today. We'll start with defensive end Anthony Zettel, who in 2019 split his time between the Cincinnati Bengals and the San Francisco 49ers. Now, a quick analysis on him. He had a very decent 2017 season, but hasn't started a game since. So the last 2 years, he's come off the bench. I think if anything, especially when you consider the fact that you have Danielle Hunter and Afedi Odenigbo, I think best case scenario, this is a depth signing. Who knows if he'll even make the official roster, the 53-man roster, by the time that the season starts, we'll have to see. I wish him all the best. Now we move on to earlier today. It was reported that the Vikings, they signed wide receiver, formerly of the Tennessee Titans, Tajae Sharpe. I don't think this necessarily changes any plans that they had to address the wide receiver group in the draft. I think, if anything, this is more of another body to possibly compete for the wide receiver 2 or wide receiver 3 spot. And actually, just off topic, when they traded away Stephon Diggs, I was really hoping that we would make a play or be in play for Robbie Anderson. That is out. He's now with the Carolina Panthers. Who knows if the Vikings even had them or had Robbie Anderson in their plans. But anyway, they move on with Tajae Sharpe. I think when it comes to this guy, less is more, because the first two seasons that he played, he missed all the 2017 season due to injury. But the first two seasons that he played, 2016 and 18, very Laquon Treadwell-esque. And what I mean by that is, if you're a wide receiver, your number one job is to catch the ball. So the first two seasons that he played, 2016, 49.5% catch rate. 2018, jumped to 55.5% catch rate. And in 2019, jumped all the way up to about 71.5%. So, hey, all right, we'll give you that. But when I say with Tajae Sharpe, less is more, because his catch percentage has gone up the lower the targets that he gets. So in 2016, the worst catch rate that he's had at 49.5%, he had 83 targets. That following season, or the following season that he played after missing 2017 due to injury, 2018 went from 83 targets to 47. His catch rate jumped up about 6 percentage points. Then in 2019, he dropped 12 targets from 47 to 35, and it went up to 71.5%. So he's going from one run-first offense to another, from the Titans with Derrick Henry to now the Vikings with Dalvin Cook. For my money, I think BC Johnson is better. So worst case scenario right here, or best case scenario right now as it stands, not including whatever the Vikings decide to do in the draft, I think Tajae Sharpe would be your wide receiver 3 if the season were to start today. But hey, they brought in more bodies to compete, to fill out the depth and the bench and all that good stuff. We'll see what officially happens. If they sign any other players, we'll be sure to get back on and do another podcast. We do this during the offseason. I don't know how many times we're going to do this a week. We'll just do it based off the signings that they make. Mediocre Best Sports Podcast with Realistic Randy. Check me out on Twitter at @Realistic_Randy. Facebook at Realistic Randy. We'll see you next time.